Hello, my name is Dr. Seema Shah Fairbank, and in this video, we will cover groundwater using Darcy's Law. Upon completion of this video, you'll be able to calculate groundwater flow based on Darcy's Law. The governing principle for groundwater flow is Darcy's Law, and that's why it's very important that we understand it. So first, imagine that we have a ground layer, where the top refers to the ground surface and the bottom is an impermeable layer. We install two wells and we measure the water surface in both, creating a water surface profile or a water table. We can measure the difference in depth between the two wells, delta H, the length between the wells, delta L, and the flow moving through it. We determine that flow rate by taking the negative times K times A times dH dL. K is called the permeability constant. This is based on experiments where we have evaluated the ground soil content and determined how the water moves through that. dH dL represents the hydraulic gradient, sometimes referred to as I. It's dH over dL, or in our case, delta H over delta L. And A is your cross-sectional area that the water sees, so the perpendicular to the flow. So let's test this out. An example. We're given two reservoirs that are connected by a porous media. Calculate the flow rate per unit width. Reservoir 1 is 50 feet. Reservoir 2 is 55 feet. Reservoir 1 is 14 feet higher than Reservoir 2. The media in Reservoir 1 is 4 feet from the bottom, while in Reservoir 2 it's 18 feet from the bottom. The media itself that the water will flow through is 10 feet high. The hydraulic constant, the conductivity constant in Area 1 is 1 gallon per day per feet squared, and the conductivity in 2 is 2 gallons per day. The distance of porous media 1 is 10 feet and porous media 2 is 34 feet. Based on this information, let's determine a flow rate. First, we know that the flow that moves through media 1 is equal to the flow through media 2, conservation of mass. K1A1 times delta H1 over delta L1 is equal to K2A2 delta H2 divided by delta L2. Remember, our cross-sectional area that the water sees is constant, so area of 1 is equal to area of 2. We set them equal to each other and we solve delta H1 is equal to 2 times delta H2 times 10 divided by 34, which is 0.59 delta H2. Next, we have to have a second equation. Delta H1 plus delta H2 is equal to the difference in the water surface, which for reservoir 1 is 50 plus 14, and in reservoir 2 it's 55. That gives us 9 feet. Now we can put 0.59 into the equation, and we get delta H2 is equal to 5.67, and delta H1 is equal to 3.33. With that completed, we're ready to find the flow rate. Remember, this is per unit width since we don't know how wide the porous media is. We do know that it's 10 feet high though. So Q is equal to, Q divided by W is equal to the K value, in our case 1 gallon per day per foot squared, times our height, which is 10 feet, times our gradient, 3.33 divided by 10. Which gives us 3.33 gallons per day per foot. We'll do additional practice examples in class to really see the application of the Darcy's equation, so that in the following week, we can start talking about confined aquifers versus unconfined aquifers.